Hey everybody, it's Momentary Flux. Welcome back to my Minimalist Factory that's using Bob's Mods. Every couple of episodes I feel sort of compelled to remind people what I'm doing here in case you're just joining the series, not from the beginning but somewhere in the middle. My idea is to make a minimalist factory that runs sort of continuously rather than sits idle all the time. I'm adding capacity. I don't want to make a factory that's not fast and efficient like some of the mega factories. I just want one that works all the time. And so I'm aiming towards that end. And we should. What I'm doing here is getting the train station set up. I need some more supplies so I can make. I can grid the power out here. I'm getting close to having everything covered. Let's get rid of this. We'll move things around a bit. Alright, so we need to replant our... I don't want to leave any gaps in coverage. There we go. Let's move one over. There we go. So our train station's almost done here. I'm glad I saw this. Train station is almost done. I've got two trains right now that are going to collect resources. I've got my Farl train, which is my personal train, which is going to be used to build outposts. And now what I want to do is I want to continue building my little weight stations. As soon as I get this track laid, here we go. Let's just run some of that up. Too far. Is that right? Yeah, I guess so. Okay, so every three spaces here, one, two, three, I'm gonna leave a gonna have a stop. And what these stops are for is that I'm going to create a circuit network that checks the contents of the logistics system and only allows trains to continue on if a resource that they're tasked to pick up is needed. So this is something I don't think I've ever seen anyone do this in a video, and it's just something I was just playing around and I'm copying this here. So what I do is I name all of these stops weight, okay? And so if all of the stops have the same name, the AI determines, you know, if there's a free one, it'll send the train down to this, to a wait station. And so all of my trains are going to, when they go to the outpost, they will go to the outpost and collect their thing, and then the second they will come back, they will unload it, and then they will go to wait. And every train will have a circuit condition set as the requirement for them to leave this wait. So let me give an example. Say that I have sent a train out to collect aluminum. I don't want my logistics system to be basically inundated with aluminum. So I'm going to set a limit of 20,000 aluminum total, aluminum ore or bauxite ore, in my system, in my logistics system. So if I have 20,000 ore, the train is never going to leave. It's just going to park there and wait for the factory to use that ore. So when the ore dips below 20,000, the train will leave and will go to the aluminum outpost, pick up more ore, and bring it back. So what I'm trying to do here is I'm trying to make it so I don't end up with like a million iron ore or a million copper ore, things that I don't need. So I think by placing limits on there, I'm following my minimalist philosophy, and I'm creating a bit more of a smarter factory. So what I will need is I'm going to need a lot of wait stations, because each resource that I go to collect is going to need its own train and it's going to need its own parking spot. Now I'm not assigning them individually, like I'm not making this a gold ore parking spot. They're going to be free flowing. And then what I'm going to do is, I think over on the side here, there are two fluids that I'm going to need to bring in. One is crude oil, and one is lithia water, which is used to make lithium batteries and lithium plates. So I'm going to probably, I will put those on the side here. And there's, let me bring up the map. There's some oil here already. So those will tie in. The crude oil will tie in with the current pumps here. And my factory that I'm going to be rebuilding will be over here. So that's the plan. So what I'm doing here is I'm just adding more weight stations. Right now, I only have two trains. I have zero outposts, so it's no big deal. But I just want to add a little bit of capacity right now. And then we'll add more later. So one, two, three. I think I'm just going to add two more for now. And I will add more later. Sort of mapping out sort of the space requirements is what this is really about. Okay. I need to get some more RoboPorts so that I can extend my network up here and chop down some more trees. What do I need? I just need circuit cards. Or actually, no, I have 200 circuit cards, so what do I really need? I need copper. Let's grab some resources. And I'm a little worried here. I'm not seeing any activity. Let's make a quick... Actually, you know what I really need to do? I need to drop some more solar panels, so I'm going to do that too. And I'm going to grab some accumulators. So it looks like we're getting thin. I know that the mining drills have been running a little bit low on the copper. Oops, didn't mean to do that. So let's add a couple more copper drills. Let's drop off some solar panels. Yeah, we're just running out. We need to make a new line here for copper. These are Mark II's. Good, okay. I'm gonna pick that one up. Get some more. This will last for quite a while. All right, we will combine our ore here with a splitter. Get some power to those guys. And that one's already got power. Good. All right, that's good. That's gonna get our copper going well again. Hopefully, I can get enough surplus power where I can start replacing these furnaces with electric. Actually, since I'm here, I'll grab a couple more. Whatever, just two. That's nothing. Steel line is looking a bit thin. I think that's just because the box is grabbing everything. Steel is really only needed right now for robots. We have quite a lot of robots, so we're okay. Head over to our solar area. So I've actually got quite a lot. I'm going to make another square. Let's get the robots going on those. A couple more robo ports. I'm not quite at the point yet where I can automate fully this system, but at least I can get them to do these. Okay. Okay. Once those robots get all back, I can move. Move this over. Get a couple more going. Okay, all 50 are back. Actually, you can run up this way. Head on over here. And I have a blueprint somewhere. That's not it. It's the one I made yellow. Yeah, that's it. Interesting. It's asymmetrical. Okay, let's put one here. And we'll put one. Can we put one above it? Got a power pole in the way. I can fix that. Okay. Yeah, I'll just put one out here in the middle. Those, I can't hardly see that line, but they do connect. Okay, good. Just clear these guys out so I have room for another solar square. I'm going to deconstruct these eventually anyway. I want something that sort of includes all of the necessary accumulators. There's just not enough here. All right, we can erase that. And let's put down a roboport. Will that cover both? Yes, it will. Excellent. And a supply box. Put everything in there. Keep those accumulators because we're making accumulator squares to make up the difference between the solar squares and the accumulators. I'm trying to keep a roughly 1-to-1 ratio with a little spare accumulator capacity. What's missing here? I think we need substations. I might have to make those. Let's make 20 substation. Oh no, there's some substations there. I'll do that many. We'll keep 10. Give it the robots. Put them to work. Okay, we've got a couple more. I think that's about all I can do for now. Let those guys fill it up. Let's make one more solar square. I can make a blueprint for that too. Drop one of those here. Drop one of those here. Or actually, ooh. Crap. It never happened. Okay, let's get another roboport. Far over, can I do it? Let's see if I can right in the middle. Okay. Some power down there. Should be able to connect through these through the substations. And now what I can do is just leave them here. Is that all of them? I think so. Okay. That ought to increase our power by another 5 to 10 megawatts. So that will help a lot. Let's check up on things here. Okay, so power is looking good. We're actually charging up now. I want to get to the point where I can remove these steam engines. Science is kind of slow. Plastic's getting made. Batteries are getting made. All the different circuits are getting made. Copper is going to be better. So it looks like we're just like a little slow on the circuits. On the intermediate circuits. I'm looking at these lights here and I'm only seeing the occasional I guess it's from... So we've got solder, we got electronic components, so it looks like the other circuits are really what's holding things up. I can definitely improve this, no problem, by making some better assemblers. So let's do that. Speed things up. I need to do the copper as well. Make sure everything's operating. Yeah, it looks like it's just the copper shortage is what's causing this to slow down. Okay, now that we've upgraded those, let's upgrade this. Actually, I think we're fine. This thing's only using one side pretty much anyway, so I think that's good. Let's take a look at copper again. I know I added more ore. In Bob's Mods, copper is definitely the big ingredient. So we're maxed out. We're going at full tilt here. So I can either add more, or I can maybe this will be my first candidate for upgrading to electric. I'm a little leery about upgrading. But we're only, we're not using all our solar capacity anymore, and we also have, I believe it's about 16 or 17 megawatts of steam that's not even being used. So I think we can start making the jump. I think we're good. Let's make a bunch of electric furnaces and get this moved over. Copper anyway. So electric furnaces have a crafting speed of 2. The stone furnaces have a crafting speed of 1. So if I make... So let's see here. We got 24 regular furnaces. So if I make around... We'll see how many will fit. I'm just going to make as many as I can. Let's drop a... We have some storage containers here. So if I set the robots to deconstruct this... it should be quick. They're close to the storage. Yeah, this is gonna kill copper, but it needs to be done. I've got enough electric furnaces now. Let's do it. Yep. Goodbye. Mark 1 furnaces. I think the thing that takes the longest is just when they're picking up belts, because they have to empty the belt of the ingredients as well. So I'm going to help them. I'm probably end up picking up a bunch of robots in the process, but that's okay. Here comes the swarm. Yeah, it looks like our construction robots are almost... They're catching up to our logistics robots in numbers. Okay. So... Let's leave 2 spaces. The reason I leave 2 spaces is because I want to put substations, which reminds me, I should probably build some. Okay, so let's grab those furnaces and line them up with our end of line. That looks about right. Okay, so 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, so that'll give us 24 electric furnaces. And they don't need coal anymore, of course. And the ore is positioned as planned, I might add. Okay. side. I don't have a blueprint yet for these. I'm gonna move this. I'm gonna move these. It's in the wrong spot anyway. Let's put it up here. I'm gonna have to leave room for the conveyor belt. And let's put another one over here. That looks good. Get some power. I guess I could use a small pull here. Alright, so we should have some substations. It should bring us to the middle of... yeah. So it'll get all the inserters, but it won't get the... it won't get the middle... the substations themselves won't connect to each other, so I'll have to put something to connect them in the middle. Alright, I'll show you what I mean in a second. I'm sure that didn't make very much sense. Actually, they do connect. Oh, no, they won't connect. I need a belt. Okay. So, what I was saying here is if you get these close enough, the substations will connect, but they're just one square too far apart to actually connect. But that's okay. What I can do is I can just put one power pole at the end here between them somewhere. Maybe it'll take two. Oh, there we go. Let's put it in the middle. Yeah, so that'll connect. I guess I need a long pull here. Actually, you know what? Let's put a substation over here. What am I thinking? Eh, it's just a bad spot, I guess. Alright, screw it. And we need some inserters. Need more inserters. These ever make any, I wonder? No, they never did. There's just, it needs too many filter inserters for it to actually get over there. I'm putting off making all the various things until I make my other factory. I just don't want to set things up here and then have to, it's just more stuff to move. In case you're wondering. Looks like we're one short on furnaces. Let's find that. Yeah, there we go. Nuke this power pole. Add a little more belt. And continue on. Final one. Looks like we need a splitter here. I have a feeling these might be... oops, wrong side. I have a feeling this might be too much capacity for yellow belt, so I may end up having to upgrade that. The copper line. Or else switch it to robot delivery. I don't think the robots are really fast enough quite yet for that, but... with more technology, they'll get faster. And I someday will be making the Mark II robots. Which I can't do yet, but eventually. Okay, look at that. Yeah, now we're looking good. Let's follow the progress of the copper and see how that has, what kind of impact that has on our production. about to hit these guys. Basic circuit boards. There we go. That looks better. It could be better. But I upgraded these. I upgraded all these, so it's not going to look as good. But we do have a drastically improved output, which is really going to boost things up here. These are already the blue assemblers. So yeah, it looks good. Okay. So next episode, we're going to get back to our train station. We're going to start looking at hooking up this aluminum. I think I'm going to belt the aluminum over because this is going to sort of no man's land. If our trains... I'm going to send some trains over here for oil and whatever this is. I think it's iron, but I'm not sure. It could be tin. And we got gold up here, more copper. These things are a little bit hard to identify. I need to build some turrets and go out and clean up some biter nests. Yeah, that's going to be another task. Okay, well anyway, I'm going to call it an episode here, everybody. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. And if you haven't subscribed, please do. Please like the video. It's totally appreciated when they're liked because I feel like my videos are kind of buried, you know. I've done some searches and I've looked at them, and I'm on like page 4 or something like that of even for the current week. So if you want to make any comments or like things, it would help me a lot just to get a little visibility. And I will see you next episode. All right, thanks.